We have all likely seen conditional formulas in Excel. A conditional formula in Power Query can be thought of in three parts. The first part is the if statement that says if the first condition is true, then we return its corresponding result, and otherwise we move to the next condition in the formula. There is only one if statement in the formula. The second part is the else if statement that says if the second condition is true, then we return its corresponding results. There can be any number of else if statements in the formula. The third and final part is the else result that the formula returns if none of the previous conditions are true. There is only one else statement in the formula. Also remember that if we set a condition equal to a text value, this value must be in quotation marks. We are going to create a conditional formula to determine what decade we need to use to measure the inflation. What we're hoping to do is be able to group the years into decades to look at the inflation as a whole. In this case, I want to get the last digit that is in the year. We first need to make sure that this is a text value. Go ahead and change the data type in year to text. Let's go ahead and create a custom column, and we're going to say decade. I'm going to set this up as text and pointing to the year and one. So returning the last digit on the end of the string. You'll see that this goes ahead and returns what we see here in the last digit in the year. However, let's go back into the formula and click on the formula here to get back into it. And I'm going to set this up as an if statement. So I'm going to say if the last character in this is equal to zero, then I'm going to go ahead and return the year, else I'm going to return null. Let's go ahead and click OK. We see here that we have returned the decade. If it is the first year of a decade, it returns that decade. Otherwise, it doesn't return anything. Go ahead and set this equal to a whole number. And there we have it. We've used a conditional formula to create another column. One more thing to note is that there is a conditional column pop-up window. However, one important thing to note is that if we could say year equals enter a value, we can select a column. One issue we see is that it's very difficult to go ahead and to set it up equal to another formula. Therefore, going down the custom column route is often the best route to go down. So what I want to do here is I'm interested in creating a calculated column that measures the rate of inflation from 1975 to 1985. So in order to create a calculated formula, I need to take this inflation rate, which is a percentage, and divide it by 100 to get the rate. Then I'm going to take the rate for each of these time periods between 1975 and 1985 and add 1 to it to get the factor of the inflation. And then I'm going to multiply each of those years together to get the inflation factor over a 10-year period. So let's go ahead and do that. Go into Add Column, create a custom column as we saw before. So I'm going to call it Inflation Factor. And I'm going to start typing in the formula. Now it's going to be 1, as I mentioned earlier, plus the first year that we're going to do this is, I'm interested in 1975. Divided by 100, and then we're going to multiply this by the next year. We can do it that way, or we could just kind of take a shortcut. So here we're just going to go ahead and copy this last piece of the formula and paste it to cover all the years. 75, 7, 8. There we have it. We've multiplied 1 plus the inflation factor for every year between 1975 and up to 1985, well, the end of 1984. Last, I'm going to go ahead and click OK. We see here that the inflation factor is a new column in this table. We can also see that some of them do not have any values in them, and this is because some of them may not necessarily be populated those years. But this is just an example of how to do a calculated formula. Lastly, we're just going to go ahead and change this to a decimal number, and we're also going to go ahead and delete all the columns except this country column here that's currently named geo. Go ahead and type it in as country. Then click on the country name, scroll all the way over, control, click on the inflation rate, right click, remove other columns, which is below remove columns. There we have it. We have a new column containing calculated formulas.